Okay, we're going to try something new today. I created a prosthetic. This is a scrape wound, as you can see. And we're going to try a different type of silicone transfer, something that I think a lot of people will have the resource to make instead of the nice silicone ones that we've made in the past. We're going to try a different thing today. First of all, I've sculpted out my prosthetic, as you can see, and I've added a small wall. And I made a specific height because that is how high my silicone mold will be. First of all, I want to seal it. I just want to seal it so I can get any of the chemicals or whatever's inside there from reacting to my... So now I'm going to let this dry, and then I will add the silicone to it. So the silicone we're going to be using for this prosthetic transfer is stuff you can buy at any hardware store. This I bought from Lowe's. They have the basic same thing at Home Depot or other type of stores that carry silicone. This is says 100% silicone. This is white, so it's been pigmented. It says silicone 2, which I think from what I read, it's more of a fast setting. When we apply this, we're going to apply this a very thin coat to it, and the thin coat, we're going to let that set first. The reason is this silicone is a bit different than this type of silicone. This stuff sets. No matter how thick you make it, it cures and it sets. This stuff, if it's too thick, it takes a really long time to set because it doesn't have any contact to air. So we're going to put a thin layer on it, and we're going to actually build it up in layers. So this is what we're going to do first. So I have my silicone in a caulk gun, as you can see here, and I'm going to coat the edge first. I don't want to put it inside of the mold yet because I want to be able to paint it in gently. So I have my brush here, and I'm just going to paint it in because my goal is to not disturb the detail, but to get the silicone into the detail gently to minimize air bubbles. So I am just coating it, and like I say, I'm not doing a thick layer at first. My first layer is going to be a nice thin layer so that it will set and that I can get a good piece from it. Now I'm going to let this cure. And once it's cured, I'm going to add another layer and probably about four layers until I get to this top surface of this clay. And then I'll have my prosthetic transfer mold. All right, it feels pretty dry. It's been about 4 hours. Like I said, I did a nice thin coat. And this stuff does dry pretty quick. So we're going to add another coat on it right now. Also, I took this brush and I wiped out the silicone really quick with a paper towel, and it's reusable. So I'm going to keep using this brush and smearing it in. Like I say, this is just a nice, another nice, fairly thin coat. My first coat, I tried to get it super thin because I wanted to make sure that it got into all the detail of the sculpture. So I'm going to let this set and cure, and then come back in about 3-4 hours and put another coat. Okay, I let it dry overnight. So now I'm going to add my last coat. We're going to use a popsicle stick to scrape it so it has a nice flat surface. Now I'm going to let this set for 4 or 5 hours or overnight, whatever you want to do, and then we can pull it out. All right, I left it overnight. Feels really nice and dry. Let's go ahead and take it out. Well, it came out really nice, real simple. All I gotta do is trim the edges off here, and looks like a really nice piece to make prosthetic transfers with. Now we're gonna go ahead and trim this a little bit, just so it looks nice and clean. It feels a little denser than our traditional silicone that I use, but, and it's not as flexible. It feels a little bit stiffer, but I think it'll work just fine. Now I'm gonna clean all this out with some naphtha and make it look nice. All right, let's take our naphtha and go ahead and clean the clay out. You can use a toothpick or other tools. Just have to be careful that you don't scratch your silicone and tear it. I don't think this silicone is as durable as the traditional silicones we use for prosthetic molds. So I'm trying to be, I'll be very careful with this one. Just being gentle as I clean it off. And I think I have a nice piece there to make my prosthetic with.